speculation is mounting over who will be as president. Donald Trump is new chief of staff after the man believed to be the top candidate that he too was leaving the government. Nick Ayers, chief of staff to the vice president, will reportedly return to his home state of Georgia. The subtract-year-old was seen as Mr. Trump's main choice to replace General Kelly, who will depart by the year's end. But the president appeared to dismiss the idea. He had wounded Mr. Ayers. I'm in the process of interviewing some really great people for the position of White House Chief of Staff, he said. In a tweet, fake news has been saying with certainty it was Nick Ayers, a spectacular person who will always be with our GMAGA agenda. I will be making a decision soon. Exactly who is on the list of interviewees is this a soft debate among us media outlets. According to the Washington Post, Republican Congressman Mark Meadows, the leader of the far-right House Freedom Caucus, and Mitt Mulvaney, the White House's budget director, are in contention. CNN added Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin to the list of possibilities, although this was played down by his source close to the former investment banker. But exactly who will be brave enough to take on the role remains to be seen. Chris Wickle, author of The Gatekeepers, How the White House Chiefs of Staff Define Every Presidency, showed Political. You really do have to wonder why anybody would want to be Donald Trump's White House Chief of Staff, given that so far it has been mission impossible. Earlier this year, John Kelly, who took over from Rex Priebus in July 2017, was forced to deny he had called Mr. Trump an idiot after the quote was included in a book about Mr. Trump by the veteran investigative journalist Bob Woodward. John Kelly is said to have used the description repeatedly, and also allegedly said that it's pointless to try to convince him of anything. Mr. Ayers' name emerged as a possible replacement last month as reports of John Kelly's deteriorating relationship with the president began to circulate, but on Sunday, he made it clear he would not be taking on the role. In a tweet saying he was resigning from the White House, "Thank you Audrey and Donald Trump at VP and my great colleagues for the honor to serve our nation at the White House. I will be departing at the end of the year, but will work with the GMAGA team to advance the cause." George end of Twitter post by Nick Ayers. According to Political, Mr. Ayers' friends have suggested he wants to run for public office in his home state, Georgia. However, CNN said to sources that First Lady Melania Trump and some other senior staff had intervened to block Mr. Ayers.